I'm Becca, this is my husband Dan. We are just going to start our day now, and it is 1 p.m. But we are going to start our day with a coffee. So it's been really cold here, so that's why we haven't left the house yet. So we live in a town called Kalgoorlie, which is located in Western Australia, in Australia. I think our population is around 28,000, but I think it's dropped in the last few years. I'm pretty sure it was more than that a couple of years ago. So it's more of a mining town, but it's more family oriented than it used to be back in the day. We have all different nationalities here. So got your Australians, then you've got South Africans, got Maoris, New Zealanders, Tongans, Africans, Filipinos, there's a Filipino community. What else? But majority are like New Zealanders that live in Kalgoorlie. The Samoans in Kalgoorlie, it's a very small community, and we've only just started to get together and do things. So hopefully we can get like something going for the Samoans to get together more often, because it's always good just to have that, you know, that connection to your roots. Hey.
That's right.
So the town is, it's a pretty small town. You can drive from one end to the other in the span of 10 minutes, 10, 15 minutes. So everything is close. Sorry, this guy should be at work today, but he tested positive last night for COVID. So he is my driver today. I don't know if he's been popping out anyway, because it's such a small town. Like, if someone from his work sees him, like, I don't know, the word just gets around in this small town very quick. You don't care?
Fine.
So this coffee place that we are going to, it's my go-to coffee place. I'm like there every day. I'm sure I'm the one that keeps this business running. And then after that, there's a store here that's from Perth. It's a business, I can't remember exactly what the name was, but once we get there, we'll figure out what the name is. I'll ask them. But they sell like clothing and just like, just fob gears and stuff like that. So they did message me saying that they had some State of Origin gear, so we're just gonna go see if they've got any New South Wales gears in stock. So we've just arrived to our coffee place, the Propaganda. I don't know if you can see that.
You can see the fussy guy on the window.
So it's just a drive-through coffee. So what do you do for work, Dan?
Just a process tape machine.
It's always just
at the nickel smelter.
So Dan works for BHP. He's been there for how long now?
On and off, 14 years.
14 years. When did you arrive in Kalgoorlie?
2007.
So I arrived in 2010. I currently work at the Railway Motel. I'm a duty manager. And I also run my own business. So I've got a shop on the main street in town, so I do lash extensions on the days that I'm not at the motel. So that I've been doing that for about almost a year now. But we'll talk about that in another video when I show you my shop and everything.
What is this video? Just an introduction?
Yeah, just an introduction. I just thought we should get started. I don't know. We don't know how to do this vlogging stuff, so we're just gonna give it a go.
So what's your coffee?
A hazelnut latte with extra hazelnut. I have a large. So these are our main traffic lights in town. We have four sets of traffic lights and a fifth and another one to make it five. That's just like when you leave town to go to Perth. Yeah. So we have four sets of traffic lights. These are the main ones. So over here we have the Exchange Hotel.
What do they serve?
Over here we have the famous Gold Bar. And upstairs is the Palace Balcony Restaurant. So that's a really nice restaurant, and then there's a restaurant behind that. Oh. We'll drive down the main street to give you guys a look. So there's a lot of historical buildings. So dome, but that's not even open anymore. This is our courthouse. We're coming up to my lash business. We'll go past there. So it's just there, just before Lowe's. So we have heaps of pub restaurants. This whole street is just like all pubs. So people usually start from one end, do a pub crawl, and then finish the night off at the other pub at the end of this street. This is, used to be called Judd's, now it's called the Kalgoorlie Hotel. I don't even know if F45 training is still open. Are they still in business, hon?
Yeah, I think so. They're still going. Still going pretty strong.
And this is the Kalgoorlie Visitor Center. And that is the town hall, the main entrance there. So if you're ever traveling, this is the town information center. We're just on our way to these guys' store that came down from Perth. So I think they're located out the front of Woolies. How rude. How big is that bird shit on my window? So this is the Kalgoorlie tram tour. So it's a tram, but it's got wheels, but it takes you around town to all the tourist destinations, attractions, Red Rooster. Their store is here. So I think their store is just over here. Oh, JR&M. Okay, guys, everyone that lives in Melbourne, this is my brother-in-law's business. JR&M Constructions. She has a building, his own building business. So hit him up for any building needs. And I designed that logo. Mm-hmm. So we are here at the store. How cool. Hi. What's the name of your guys' business?
Half Cast Designs.
Half Cast Designs. It's going on my YouTube channel.
Oh, man. Are you
picking up? Yeah.
Hi.
Nice to meet you. Yeah. See, everyone knows
what's
me, guys.
Channel? What's your channel for?
It's Becca Yosefa. So we're just starting here.
Yeah. Are you based up here?
Yeah. In Kalgoorlie.
Do you come down to Perth much?
Yeah. We come quite a bit. Hey. Yeah. Like maybe once a month we always come down.
What do we look for?
This was the last one.
Yeah, we've only got four.
That is nice, that Samoa one, eh? Check this out, guys.
Oh, this one's
nice.
And the white too,
someone.
Where are
they? You've got them all charged. Yeah, that's nice. Yeah, yeah. Final shout out.
Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome to our store in Kalgoorlie. This is Halfcast Designs. We sell all different merch. State of origin, we've got some Samoan gear, Māori, Fijian, even got some Bob Marley cookie gear. So look us up, Half Cast Design. No love. Awesome. Shout out to
Becca.
Shout out to Becca and her lovely partner. Thank you, appreciate
you. All good. Okay, so we just purchased. What did we get? We got two New South Wales
singlet
jerseys and a beanie. So the New South Wales basketball singlets were 75 each. She gave us a discount, and the beanie was 40, but she gave it for 20. So we got a bargain today. So they'll also be at the Multicultural Festival tomorrow, the 10th of July. So if you're in Kalgoorlie, definitely hit them up. So I think we will go for a drive to the Super Pit and give you guys a look at the Super Pit. That's one of our main attractions in Kalgoorlie. So I think it's, is it still KCGM or is it Northern Star?
I think it's a merger.
Well, it's one of those companies, KCGM or Northern Star. So, what is it? It's just like a massive hole in the ground where they've just been digging and digging. So they got trucks that go down there. So I think, I don't know if I'm right, how long does it take to drive down and then up? Do you know?
There's a couple of hours in the truck.
So, not exactly how many hours, but it's a couple of hours to drive down and then back up. So that's how big the hole is. So obviously they dig in the hole because they're looking for gold. I don't think I know anyone that works at over there. Yeah, so they have bus tours and that go there. Whenever we have family that come to Kalgoorlie, we take them there. Then certain times during the day, they do like they have blast. So they just, I don't know, explosives, and then it just like, what is it, just to blast like parts of the hole?
Yeah, so it's to dig through the rock, so they use the explosives to break up sections of the super pit, so it's easier to dig through in that.
All right, so we're coming up to the highway, which is like our only highway in Kalgoorlie.
This is State Route 94.
State Route 94, the Goldfields Highway. We're here now at the Kalgoorlie Super Pit with this COVID guy. Isn't it nice being outside and walking and having fresh air? I never go out. I always just stay home. This is not what I do every day. What do you mean, catfish? I'm not telling them that I'm active and... So it's very brown, in brown and red in Kalgoorlie. We hardly have any green grass. That is one thing I miss about Melbourne.
Melbourne's a bit cold.
No, it's not. How big is that? Go stand in that, hon. Hold it. All right, he's gonna show you how big this is. That's like a rough size of what they have on the dump trucks down the bottom. Oh, what do we have here? Can you do me?
Hello, Melissa.
All right, let's show you guys the lookout. What's your reading there?
125 years. So this is the Kalgoorlie Boulder, the discovery of the richest square mile on earth.
Discovery of the richest square mile on earth. 1893. This has gone much deeper than the last time I came here. Just see if I can zoom in.
So my understanding is some of the holes that you see inside, like on the walls of the super pit, are like old mine shafts from years ago.
So my understanding is, I thought they weren't using this site anymore because it actually collapsed a couple of years ago. So you can see there where it collapsed.
Oh, yeah.
So apparently... So when this collapsed, there was like ash in like all of Kalgoorlie. Like, it was pretty scary that day. I didn't know what was going on. I didn't know it was from the super pit.
So where are they digging now?
So apparently they're digging down over there somewhere. Oh, so okay. I think where that road is up there,
yeah.
And it goes to the other side where they're now digging the other side.
Yeah, I was wondering why
it was. Because of the collapse, yeah. Look how small that truck looks down there. Just to give you an idea of the size of the hole, how small the movements are. Some trucks there as well. I'll take you inside because there's like more info and stuff. So it's North KCGM and Northern Star, so 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. daily. Then the blasting times, you need to scan for the times for the blasting.
From the golden mile to over 60 million ounces in the 120 years since the lease was first backed. Community.
St. Barbara's Festival. So we have this festival every year. And Danswerk BHP, they usually go down for the parade. I should actually put up a video of him walking with the Samoan flag at that parade last year. The mining process. Just explaining the mining process from geology to blasting. In our backyard, we don't even live far from here. We're like a 5-minute drive from here, so when they do the blast, we definitely feel it at home. So that was the super pit.
It's just talking to old mate over there right now.
No, you were gone for ages.
No, he was filling me in about I think years ago. You know how like we've got a tourist mine where you can sort of go underground in that?
Yeah.
But years ago apparently you could come to the apparently you could come to the super pit
and go underground,
and you could go in one of the old shafts, mine shafts there. And it was like all done up and stuff, but
where are we going now?
To go look at the things that they use.
Can meet my mom. So my mom lives in Kalgoorlie as well, and my baby brother and my older brother and my younger sister. So it's just my baby sister. She's the only one that lives in Melbourne now, but the rest of us all live in Kalgoorlie, so we might go pop in and say hi. She loves the camera, so I'm sure she'll love being on video. So I'll show you how close everything is. So we just left the super pit and we are going to visit mum. So I'll just record the drive there. This is the famous Birch Street in Boulder. Good old Boulder. So we live in Boulder. We don't have any like shopping centers or anything like that, so it's just like, so this is the main street in Boulder that has shops, and then in town is Haddon Street, which is also just a street of shops. So you can see all the buildings, like they're so old. This roundabout, it goes to Dan's work, which is down that way, but we are going up this way. So if you haven't been to WA before, we have chicken treat. So if you ever visit, you have to go. They have the best fried chicken. This is my kids' primary school that they went to when they were in primary school. So this is Boulder Primary. And both my sons, they were both head boy for this school when they were both in, when they were in year six. So that was pretty cool. Head boy, yeah.
Boy over now.
We have the worst drivers here, I swear. Like, she stopped in the middle of the road, but we're at a giveaway. Oh, they said they're two. Alright, so two clubs. At this footy field, Mines Rovers Footy Club and Boulder City Football Club.
So we actually had a player that used to play for Boulder City Football Club, and he's just made it into the
AFL.
I don't know if it was North Melbourne, the Kangaroos. It was, or Collingwood, it was one of those teams, so that was pretty cool. He's a born and bred Boulder boy, making big moves. So we're now on Lionel Street. This is the Bronx. Like and what it looks like. I told you we have no grass. Look at that. It's just like red dirt. It's a desert. Johnston Street. Where all the fun happens at night. Sometimes at night you could be driving on this road and you could get like a smashed window from someone just throwing a rock and you don't even know where it came from. Mom's already. That's Mom's house. That's her backyard. At the end of this street is Liev's high school. Oh, they always lock the gate, man. The queen is here.
Jerry, because I'm lucky.
Yes. How rude. I beeped the horn and no one even came. Hello. So yeah, guys, I just got here and my mum's at bingo. She went with my other sister, so how rude. So you don't get to meet her today. So let's go. Let's go back to the car. Bye, Wes. Love you. Bye.
No, you say you are. Why am I not swaffer? Because other people.
That's a respectful way.
I'll be like,
oh,
I love
swaffer. Why are you not swaffer? Yeah, what the hell?
But anyway, no, but you know,
Samoa is
getting so good. You never show respect
to yourself, true. Sorry. My sister right. Yeah. Which is
she moved to Samoa last year.
I don't respect
sorry.
Myself.
Nah. In fact, Samoa's been getting really good. Two high schools in Kalgoorlie?
Three.
Or three high schools? But this is the only public one. So this goes up to year 10. And then 11 and 12 is in town. Hi, Lua. That's my sister-in-law, Lua. We're all doing school pickups. Say hi to my YouTube channel.
Hi.
Hi.
Not you.
Not you. Oh.
Stay ready, though. Stay ready.
Stay ready, girl.
I do.
I try myself. It's my nephew waiting. Hi, Brayden. Say hi to my YouTube channel. How was school? Ella's coming.
Yeah.
That's my niece Ella. Hi Ella. Say hi to my YouTube channel. There's Ella. Yeah. My nephew Malachi. I swear Liev is like the last kid to walk out of the school. Hi Malachi. Here.
Oh hi.
Say hi to my YouTube channel. Oh, there's my son. He's trying to hide. He's hiding. All right, I'm gonna walk out and record him. Hi, son. Say hi to my YouTube channel. What, are you embarrassed?
No. I also like on the car.
How's school?
685.
Yeah. 685. Bye, guys. Bye. Look, son, we got you New South Wales stuff.
Oh, I thought this was.
It's not bad.
You like it?
Thank you.
Okay, stop, man.
It's my YouTube channel.
Oh, how's it going, guys?
Did you go to school today?
Yeah, man.
Lincoln, did you go to school today?
Bro, I attended all my classes. Wow.
Look at the camera.
Hey, guys.
This is my baby.
Okay, baby.
Alright, let's finish. What about the jerseys?
So we found him. I don't even know if this kid went to school today.
Did you walk away from my friends?
Yeah, right.
Where are we going? How's
school?
Maccas.
Are you shouting?
Are you shouting?
I'll shout.
Yo.
Do you have money?
I have money, but I don't know.
Oh, look at that, though. That's a good idea. So you're right, Donnie.
What?
This would be a Great Northerns, mate.
And to the right, and I'm like...
Stop it!
Look at this guy. Box of beer for Friday night.
What's Friday night?
What is Friday night? Friday night.
I think it's I might Friday have that.
Hey, we're gonna do the bank.
When?
After this.
Yeah, pizza.
I don't care.
Go.
What'd you learn today, Lincoln?
Our maths teacher let me
listen. Linear equations.
Equations?
Linear equations.
Oh, what's linear?
Linear is like.
I don't know, bro. Straight. I just know.
Linear motion.
Am I a bro?
No, ma'am.
Ma'am?
I don't know anything to guys because I'm too small. I'm passing with my glasses, which is except for languages, because languages is trash.
Languages is trash. Why? Because you're 100% Samoan?
Yeah. I don't need to learn about other cultures.
Really? I'm 100% Samoan. I told you that's my Benny. Stupid ass.
Where are we going now?
Macca's.
Oh my gosh.
Why are we wearing a mask?
Because it's cold.
It's because if someone sees dad from work, he's wearing a mask. Okay, that's why he's wearing a mask.
Fuck him. Just protecting from you guys getting sick.
You want a ticket?
Just grab it. Check it.
Thank you.
Oh, busted. I knew he eats the fries. Yeah, Link.
Stop eating it.
It's like straight away. Bro. Stuffed his mouth with the fries. You got caught on camera. Like.
I was looking for the burgers.
So how did the chips end up in your mouth?
It fell.
So we're just on our way home now to eat our food.
Oh no, everyone said that's not
there. Did you remember back in the day after school when your parents used to take you to McDonald's? Because I don't. Man, kids these days, they're so spoiled, eh? I'm watching you, Liam.
Don't eat it, man.
I don't even need it.
Don't eat it, man.
What are you?
Come on.
What? Nugget. We got some mail today. Oh. Wow, the rendezvous. We just got an invite for my cousin's wedding in Perth. December 29th. That is so cool. Oh, I'm looking forward to that. So, we just got home and they didn't even give me any sauce for my nuggets. Why wouldn't you give sauce for nuggets? McDonald's always gets something wrong. So, thanks for joining us today. We wrap this vlog up and hopefully you'll come and join us on our next video. Everyone's hungry, no one's talking. Thanks for joining us today, guys. We hope to see you on the next vlog, and not that I can see you, but you can see us. But I don't know how they do all this thing. I'm just new to this thing, so okay, bye guys.